Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's Bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing recursion in Java. And at the end of this video, we're going to be creating a program where we use a recursive method to simulate somebody walking. So let's get into it. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. Hey everyone, so we're going to be discussing recursion, and this is defined as the process in which a method calls itself continuously, and a method that calls itself is called a recursive method. So what is this useful for? Well, I'm glad you asked. It's useful for things such as factorials, transversing trees, and basically just simplifying a complex task. Now, to best demonstrate this, we're going to call a method from within our main method. And when we reach the end of this method, it's going to keep on calling itself, and it'll end up being like some sort of infinite loop. So let's create a method. Perhaps we'll call this hello world, because I couldn't think of anything creative at the moment. And then outside of our main method, we're going to make a hello world method that is static. We'll make it void. It won't return anything. And the method name will be hello world. There'll be no parameter set up. And all we're going to do is maybe just print the words hello world. All right, let's just try this once just to be sure it works, and it in fact does. Now, what we're going to do at the end of our method is actually call this method again. So if we were to run this, what ends up happening is that we get a bunch of problems here. So let me scroll up to see what happens. So it keeps on repeating itself. It's as if we're stuck within an infinite loop, and the program actually encounters an exception, a stack overflow error, because we ran out of memory, basically. So with recursion, we want some way to limit how many times this is going to execute. So we can actually add something called a base case. So this is kind of like our condition. So what I'm thinking we can do is pass in how many times we want this hello world function to actually execute or run, because we don't want it to run infinitely. So let's say that we want hello world to be called 3 times. So let's just begin by passing in the number 3. Now we'll need to set up some parameters within our method here. Now for the parameters, we're just going to set up a single integer, and we'll call this value n, whatever value is sent here. And then since we're calling this method at the very end, we also need to send back whatever n is. So like, since we're calling our function from within the function, we have to send it an argument, so we're going to send n. Now, what we'll need to do is put this within an if statement. So this is going to be our base case. We want this process to execute if n is greater than maybe 0. And then we'll surround all of this with a set of curly braces. Now we'll need to decrement our counter. So before we call hello world, we're going to decrement n by 1. And I think what we'll do is just display whatever our index is. So maybe I'll say hello world space, then the number. So let's run this now. Yeah, and you can see here that hello world executed 3 times and no more than that. So why is this useful? Now, if this was like an ordinary function, if we wanted to display the word or words hello world 3 times, well, we would have to normally like copy this function and call it 3 separate times, which can be cumbersome. But now if we use a recursive method, we can just basically put a number here of how many times we want to call this function, and it's going to just keep on repeating itself until this base case is done, basically. Now, if we wanted to repeat hello world 10 times, we could just pass in the number 10. And this recursive method will actually just take care of it for us, and we only have to call this once, but we'll want to pass in how many times we want this to repeat. And you can see here that it repeated 10 times. Now, let's combine this with some user input. So before we call our hello world recursive method, what we're going to do is set up a scanner. Scanner scan equals new scanner system.in. And then we will have a prompt, and we will ask, how many times do you want to say hello? That's kind of an odd question, but it makes sense for this project. and then we will accept some user input and store it within a variable such as integer number. So integer number equals the name of our scanner, which is scan dot next int. All right, and then instead of placing the like a raw number in here, like an integer, we're just going to place our variable number. So we're going to replace 10 with number. So let's try it now. How many times do you want to say hello? 420 times. And let's just check this. Yep, it repeated hello world 420 times. So with recursion, basically it's the process in which a method calls itself continuously, and a method that calls itself is called a recursive method. So we're actually going to put this to use now. We're going to work on a project that simulates somebody walking, and we're going to create a recursive method for somebody taking a single step and call it so many times depending on how far somebody wants to walk. So let's work on that now. Well, welcome back everyone. So we're going to create a recursive method that's going to function as taking a single step, because one useful thing with recursive methods is that they can be used to simplify a complex task. So for a complex task such as walking, we can break it down into its most simple form, taking a single step. And then we can just use that recursive method to call itself a bunch of times to simulate walking, basically. So what we'll do is that we'll create some user input. We'll accept some user input by using a scanner. We'll call this scanner scan equals new scanner system.in. And then make sure you have this import as well. And then what we'll do is ask for some user input. And we will ask, how far do you want to walk? And let's ask for this in meters. And then we will store some user input. And let's store this within maybe integer distance equals scan dot next int. All right, so this distance variable is going to store how far we want to walk, and this is going to be within meters basically. Now let's create a method called take a step, and we're going to set up two parameters. So we're going to set up two arguments. So we'll send in 0, that's like our starting position, like we're at 0 meters right now. And then we will also send our distance variable to our take a step method. So outside of your main method, we're going to declare and set up this take a step method. So this will be a static method that is void, and it is called take a step. And there are two parameters to set up. The first is an integer, and we will call this maybe I. It's going to be our counter, basically. It's going to display the distance we're currently at. We're currently at 0. And we will also accept an integer that will function as our distance. Okay, the next step now is that we'll want a base case. So if our counter I, which is where we're currently at, which is at 0 to begin with, is less than distance, how far we want to walk, what we'll do is first we'll increment our counter. So this is as if we're taking a single step. And then we'll display a message for the user. And maybe we'll say, you take a step plus I, which is our counter. And then maybe we'll add the word meters after this, meter/s. And then for the next line, we're going to call take a step again, but we need to pass in whatever our current counter is, our current position, which is I. So after the first iteration, it's going to be 1, and it's going to keep on incrementing. So I, as well as our distance. Okay, so then once we finish this base case, we're going to put an else statement, and we'll just display a message such as, you are done walking. And that's all there is to it. Let's run this. How far do you want to walk? And this is in meters. So let's say we want to walk 1,000 meters. That's 1 kilometer. So we'll type in 1,000. And here it shows us taking a step. Our first step is 1, and it continues all the way down until we reach 1,000 meters, 1 kilometer. And then it says we are done walking. So that's the basics of recursion. It's the process in which a method calls itself continuously, and a method that calls itself is called a recursive method. And these are used for things such as factorials, traversing trees, and simplifying a complex task such as walking, where we can just break it down into a simple step such as taking a single step and then repeating it continuously using a recursive method to simulate something complex such as walking. So that's your introduction to recursion. If you would like a copy of all this code that we worked on, I'll post it in the comments down below and pin it to the top. And your assignment is to create a recursive method and post it in the comments section. But yeah, that's the basics of recursion in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.